We're going to be learning to make shortcut tortilla soup. So this is great for all the housewives that you don't want to spend all night in the kitchen cooking. This is how you get it done quick. 5-quart Dutch oven. Helps if you start the right burner. Go. Medium heat, little olive oil into the pan. Now, I picked up a package of the pre-chopped onions from my grocery store, which equals close to 2 cups. And then I diced up 2 cups of celery because you want a 1-to-1 ratio. And unfortunately, they don't have it already pre-cut, or I'd have got that. Into the pan it goes. Now, we're going to saute that until the onion is translucent and the celery is soft. So that's going to take a few minutes. Okay, 2 quarts of water. That's to start with. We'll probably use another 2. I'm going to go ahead and turn that up to high because we're going to start adding our other vegetables. So the hardest vegetables go in first. That's your carrots. Anybody doing a keto diet, you're probably not going to want to add the carrots, or maybe not add as many. This was one of those packages of pre-sliced carrots that you can get from your grocery store. They're kind of a crinkle cut, pretty nice. They'll cook fairly quickly. They should be done in 20 minutes. So they're all going in next. Also going in at this time is sort of a surprise ingredient. I don't use potatoes. I peel and cube turnips. And it's delicious, and most people don't even know they're eating turnips. They think it's potatoes. Now this was one large turnip, or you can use 3 small. Give you about the same amount. Now you'll notice that I haven't added any salt or anything like that yet. So it's going to depend on the flavor of your vegetables, your chicken, everything that you're putting in here. Plus what kind of chicken base or chicken broth or chicken bouillon that you use. This is the kind I use. I get it off of Amazon. I really like it a lot. This is what I use anytime I am going to use some type of chicken broth. And I am just going to get basically 1 heaping tablespoon, big tablespoon of broth, because that's a lot of water we've got in there. Now this particular chicken base is not as salty as most bouillons are. So one of the reasons why I like it. I like to be in control of the salt. So, here we go. Go ahead and do that. We're going to put the lid on and let that come to a boil. Just waiting for it to boil, then we're going to turn it down to a simmer. Let it simmer for about 5 minutes, then we are going to add. I have some chopped squash, and you can use any version of this that you want. In this case, it's like 1 yellow squash, 1 chayote squash, and 2 small zucchinis. But any combination, or you know, just use zucchini, it doesn't matter. It's all going to be good. So whatever your family likes the best, that's what you put in. Turn that down. Now my burner still keeps a pretty good flame even at low. So I go ahead and put mine on low. But what you need to do is have yours at a simmer. You don't want it boiling anymore. You want it simmering. You want those vegetables to start cooking. And they need to cook for about 5 minutes. 5 minutes. And then we will add our zucchini, because it cooks much quicker than the other vegetables. Starting to smell pretty good. We're not there yet. Here goes our zucchini. Now, we want our vegetables to actually cook in some spices and some flavor. So it's time for the magic ingredient. Yep, taco seasoning. Now you can use the mild, you can use the spicy. I use just the regular mild. It has everything in it that I would have been digging in my cupboard for. And it tastes amazing. Now this is the brand that I like to use, but I've used others and they're good too. So you use whatever's in your cupboard. So, and to the pot it goes. Now you cook your vegetables to whatever stage of doneness that you like. I don't like them cooked to mush, so, but that's, you know, entirely whatever you like. Now I have some chopped cilantro here. And I'm gonna add about a third of one chopped bunch of cilantro. I'm gonna turn the heat back up to get my soup back up to a simmer. And we're going to simmer this till the vegetables are almost done. And then we're going to add chicken from one of those pre-cooked rotisserie chickens that you can pick up at the store. So depending on the size of your family, one or two chickens, you can get more than enough chicken for this soup. And 1/2 of a head of cabbage chopped. And I only chopped the cabbage myself because they were all out of the coleslaw mix, or I would have picked up one or two packages of those. It's already chopped for you. Just dump it in there. And we'll let that cook for 5 or 10 minutes. Okay, our vegetables are starting to get tender. And you know that, of course, by sticking them with a fork. When the fork can pierce through them easily, we're getting there. Now, we're gonna go ahead and add our chicken. Oh yeah, yeah. And we're gonna go ahead and, oh, you know what, I almost forgot my cilantro. Another third of my cilantro. Cabbage goes right on the top. Lid on till the cabbage is done, which all of you cooks out there know doesn't take that long for cabbage to cook. So we're there. We're gonna get our bowls out and get them ready. Get our garnishes ready. And I'll show you how to take that up to the next level. At this point, we're gonna go ahead and stir our cabbage into the soup. We're gonna taste it for our seasonings. Doesn't need anything. We're ready. Now to serve it. Ladle. This is very filling. This will fill up your family. I'll save a little room in the bowl for the goodies to go on. Now we like to crunch our chips up just a little bit so that we have a little room for what we're about to do. Got your chips, got your cheese. Now, little avocado, some diced tomatoes, a little extra for me, a little more cilantro, and a little dollop of sour cream. Let me know how you like it.